Sheikh Abdullah Khadra to come and talk about the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I don't see a clock here, so is the time open? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد رسول رب العالمين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا متقبلا يا أرحم الراحمين. O Allah, teach us what benefit us. Increase us in knowledge, in good morals and in good deeds, يا رب العالمين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who brought us together on the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on His love, and the love of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam taslima, and the love of His family members who followed Him and supported Him and sacrificed their lives for the sake of this religion, and also on the love of His companions from whom we learned the love of the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it's a great blessing, dear brothers and sisters, that we are gathered to have all of this combination. And I will start with an ayah that mentions Ahlul Bayt, and we'll comment on this ayah and some of the hadith on the love of Ahlul Bayt. And also I would like to comment on this blessing that Allah has blessed us with, that many people are deprived of and many people miss. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-Ahzab, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, يا نساء النبي لستن كأحد من النساء إن اتقيتن فلا تخضعن بالقول فيطمع الذي في قلبه مرض وقلن قولا معروفا وقرن في بيوتكن ولا تبرجن تبرج الجاهلية الأولى وأقمن الصلاة وَأَقِمْنَا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتِينَا الزَّكَاةَ وَأَطِعْنَا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَنْ يُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. This ayah, if you look at the context of this ayah in Surah Al-Ahzab, almost five ayat before it and three ayat after this ayah, it's all talking about the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The ayah right before this one, all women of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are not like any women. So in ittaqaytunna, if you have taqwa of Allah, do not, do not speak in a way that will make the those who have diseases in their hearts have ill thinking of you. And say good words. So when you say this to someone, doesn't mean they're doing something wrong. No, you're reminding them to continue on this path, to continue on this great virtue that they have. Then he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَقَرْنَ فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ, and stick to your houses. And this is not only for them, this is for all women after them who are supposed to follow their path. Our women, our daughters, our sisters, they are supposed to take the mothers of the believers as their role models. They're supposed to follow them in their great character. And this is why they are the mothers of the believers. So our daughters and our sisters and wives, they have to follow their mothers, the mothers of the believers, radiallahu anhunna ajma'in. And perform a prayer, Allah says, and give charity, and obey Allah and His Messenger. Then Allah says, surely, innama, surely, these teachings, innama yuridu Allah liyudhiba ankum rijsa ahli al-bayt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to keep away any mistakes or deficiency or flaws in your character. وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا, and truly and thoroughly purify you. That's the spiritual purification. And this is how they were. They are the chaste, pure, great role models. رضي الله عنهم أجمعين. May Allah be pleased with all of them. Ameen. So these ayah, the next ayah, again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذْكُرْنَ مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ. And remember and mention and teach what is being mentioned in your houses. In ayat of Allah's verses and of the wisdom. So the whole context of this ayat and of this particular word, Ahlul Bayt, is basically and originally about the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's the first point that we need to be aware of. So Ahlul Bayt, number one, by the text of the Quran, include the wives of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because they are Ahlul Bayt. They are his household. And this is why Allah says in the next ayah, fi buyutikunna, in your houses. And in Arabic, when you say Ahlul Bayt, as in the Quran, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Sayyidina Ibrahim, when he says, rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu alaykum Ahlul Bayt, he meant Sayyida Sara, by consensus of the scholars, his wife. So we as particularly people of Ahlul Sunnah, we can never compromise this. And this is the blessing that I want to talk about, that Allah blessed us with. That we don't only love the family members of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we also love his wives and his companions, all of them. That is wallahi a great blessing that we need to thank Allah for. In these days, we are not also to thank Allah for this, that in these days we are not of those people who are holding some gatherings to beat themselves and to tear their clothing and to cut themselves, claiming that they love Sayyidina al-Husayn radiallahu anhu alayhi salam, and claiming that they are sad for what happened to him. And in reality, their ancestors are the ones who betrayed him and who let him down. So it's a great blessing from Allah that we are gathering, remembering the great sacrifices of that greatest leader of the people of Jannah without exceeding the boundaries that we learned from him and from his father and from his grandfather, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. That's a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are not of those people who claim to love him, radiallahu anhu, and to love the household and Ahlul Bayt, and they curse the Sahaba, or they curse the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or some of them. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, let's think of this. Is not this a blessing from Allah? That we are in the middle, that we are not violating any of those boundaries. And also, it's a blessing that we are not of those Ahl Sunnah who are just ignoring about it. Just forget about it, brother. We don't need to remember this. Why to remember this massacre? Or why to remember these sad things? Subhanallah. Then why did this greatest Imam sacrifice? So that we ignore his sacrifices? Is this how we treat him? Is this how we deal with his sacrifices? Why did he come out? Isn't for this religion? Wasn't for al-amr bil ma'roof wa nahi anil munkar? Was it for any dunya? It was never for any dunya. It was, as he said, kharajtu talab al-islahi fi ummati jaddi. I went out to correct the mistake that's taking place in the community of my grandfather, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that's something that we need to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us on this path, the path of loving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his wives and his blessed pure wives and offspring and his sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. And that's what we learned from the sahaba, and that is what the Quran teaches us. والذين جاءوا من بعدهم يقولون ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. All, and those who came after them, after the migrants and after the Ansar, they say, our Lord, forgive us and forgive our brothers who were ahead of us in the faith, in accepting the faith, and never leave any hatred in our hearts to the believers. You are most kind and most merciful. Who are Ahlul Bayt? So Ahlul Bayt, according to the ayah, number one is the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No one can come and say, Ahlul Bayt are only Sayyiduna Ali and Sayyida Fatima and Sayyidina al-Hasan and Sayyidina al-Husayn radiallahu anhu ajma'in, and you ignore the ayah and the context of the ayat, which are all about the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, then how we believe as Ahlul Sunnah that Sayyiduna Ali and Sayyiduna al-Hasan and Husayn and Sayyida Fatima, these are Ahlul Bayt. So there is a special term for Ahlul Bayt. There are general terms and there are specific terms. Number one, who's included in Ahlul Bayt? The wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No discussion about this. Number two, Sayyiduna Ali and Sayyida Fatima and Sayyidina al-Hasan and Sayyidina al-Husayn, they had a special hadith in which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself included them in Ahlul Bayt, in this term. And this term means what? This term means they are purified. They are great. They are mutahhareen. Radiallahu anhu ajma'in. In that hadith, of course, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we know hadith al-kisa, and this is why they call him Ahlul Kisa. And in Sham we say Ahlul Aba. In our anasheed and in our celebrations, we have nasheeds about them. We say Ahlul Aba means the cloth, the people of the cloth. When our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had Sayyida Fatima and Sayyidina Hassan and Sayyidina Hussein and Sayyidina Ali, and he included them, and he said, oh Allah, these are Ahlul Bayti, these are my Ahlul Bayt, so purify them. And tahhirhum tatheera, purify them thoroughly. And in Arabic, this never means in any way that they are only Ahlul Bayt. No, this is a special trait for them, or a special characteristic for them, that they are of the special family members of mine. Radiallahu anhu ajma'in. Now, when it comes to the fiqh schools, we have some little differences. For example, in the Shafi'i school, the household of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are those to whom it's haram to give sadaqah. And from this, let's take one very nice meaning to show the respect that Allah himself wanted us to show to Ahlul Bayt. That it's haram, it's forbidden to give them out of your sadaqah. Why? Because sadaqah, as the scholars mentioned, it's the dirt of the money. It's the dirt of the money. It's awsafu mal al-nas. So you don't give them of the dirt with which you purify your money. No, you have to give them from the main part of your money. Just like your father and mother. You cannot give zakat to your father and mother. You have to give them from your main money. Just like your children. You cannot give your father and mother zakat. Why? Because they are your origin. You have to give them from the main money that you have. Not from the zakat. So this shows us the respect. Who made this rule? It's our beloved sallallahu alayhi wasallam by revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is just one example of the love and the respect that we are commanded to show to that group of those great people. Radiallahu anhum ajma'in. In the Hanafi school, they are five clans of Banu Hashim. And the Hanafi scholars, they say, Ha'un wa jim wa thalathatu uyun. They say these five clans or families of Ahlul Bayt to whom haram, it's hard to give sadaqah, are Ha and Jim and three ayns. Ha, or let's start with the uyun. The three uyun are Sayyidina Ali, his family, and Sayyidina Al-Abbas, his family, and Sayyidina Aqil. These three start with ayn. And the Ha for Al-Harith bin Abdul Muttalib, and the Jim for Sayyidina Ja'far and his family. In the Hanafi school, these five clans are considered the ones, the Ahlul Bayt, to which or to whom haram to give sadaqah. In the Shafi'i school and the Hanbali school, it's wider. It includes them and includes some other clans of Hashim and Al-Muttalib. If we look at the hadith of As-Salawat Al-Ibrahimiyya, when we make Salah Ibrahimiyya in our Salah, and if we look at the forms of those Salawat Ibrahimiyya, we find what I just mentioned in one of them, narrated by Imam Bukhari. In addition to the form that we all know, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala ali Sayyidina Ibrahim, wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad, kama barakta ala Sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala ali Sayyidina Ibrahim fil alameen, innaka hamidun majid. Another form in Sahih Bukhari, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa azwajihi wa dhurriyatihi kama sallaita ala ali Ibrahim wa barik ala Muhammadin wa azwajihi wa dhurriyatihi kama barakta ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. O Allah, raise the position and shower with more blessings Muhammad and his wives and his offspring. And that's what we're mentioning, that Ahlul Bayt are the wives and the offspring of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Of course, when we're talking about those clans of Banu Hashim, we're talking about the believers among them. And this shows you in Islam, it's not about just because this person is related to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so we have to follow him and love him. Not that by itself, but of the believers from his household members. So Abu Lahab was the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we don't love him, and he's not considered of Ahlul Bayt. And as the poet put it, that مَا ضَرَّ سَلْمَانُ الْفَارِسِيُّ أَصْلُهُ وَمَا نَفَعَ النَّسَبُ الزَّكِيُّ أَبَى لَهَا. The poet is saying that it's not about your lineage, it's about your actions. Because Salman the Persian, he was not harmed by his origin, which is from Persia. Still, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in some narrations, he said, سَلْمَانُ مِنَّا أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ. Salman is one of us. And the pure lineage of Abu Lahab did not benefit him. And this is what our beloved taught us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the authentic hadith. He said, O Fatima, save yourself from the fire, I will not benefit you. O people of Hashim, O people of, don't like just depend on your relation with me. So the main thing is the action. And for us, we love those great people who believed in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and followed him and supported him, because they are related to him and connected with him, and because of their great actions and great deeds in serving this religion. Radiallahu anhum ajma'in. Our beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to remember together some of those traditions in which we see the amazing relationship between these people that we're gathering to talk about and our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw Sayyidina al-Hassan or Hussein, as in the authentic hadith, trying to eat one of the dates that he found, he took it from his mouth sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said kikh, and he took it out from his mouth before he put it. He said kikh, أَمَا عَلِمْتَ أَنَّ آلُ مُحَمَّدٍ لَا تَحِلُّ لَنَا الصَّدَقَةِ. Didn't you know that we, the family of Muhammad, is haram on us to take from the charity? صلى الله عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله. He didn't say, oh, it's okay, it's one date.
It's one day, yalla.
No. No. Those are the pure ones. That they never had something haram in their stomachs. They are the purified ones. The ones that Allah wanted. And if Allah wants something, who can stop it? Allah said, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ. Allah wants to remove and to push away any dirt, spiritual or physical, from you, O people of household of the Prophet. And thoroughly purify you. If Allah is saying He wants to do that, who can stop Him? And will not Allah fulfill His will? Absolutely. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah purified them. And here we have to be aware, of course, that also from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us, that we don't go into extremes and we say, huh? Allah said He will purify them, so they are infallible. They don't make sins. Ahlul Bayt don't make sins. Sayyidina Ali, Sayyidina Fatima, they don't make sins. They are infallible. No. No. All of Ahlul Sunnah by consensus, they agree only Anbiya, only the prophets and the messengers are infallible. Only the messengers and the prophets are the ones who don't make sins. Everyone else could make sins. And that's again the blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we don't exceed the boundaries. And we don't make them in the level of the prophets. That is the true love for those great people. And if they hear someone who says this about them, they will stop him before anyone else. Radiallahu anhum wa Allahum ajma'in. Alhamdulillah, all praise and thanks be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who blessed us with this moderate position. In another hadith, also to see his behavior, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, himself, he says, as in the authentic hadith, sometimes I see the date on the floor and I pick it to eat it, then I remember that it might be from the date of charity. Because they used to gather the charity and the date and these things in the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then he will distribute it. So that is the house in which Sayyiduna al-Husayn radiallahu anhu was raised. Then how will his tarbiyah be? How will his akhlaq be? The best of akhlaq radiallahu anhu. And this is why it's very, what can we say? Like, it doesn't make any sense when some, especially some people of Ahlul Sunnah, they come and say that he, Sayyidina al-Husayn, he wanted to become the leader, or he wanted to... All that is nonsense for us. That is nonsense for us. That's not someone, that's not something who can be attributed to this great imam. That's a man about whom sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Al-Hasan wal-Husayn sayyida shababi ahli jannah. They are the masters of the youth of Jannah. And he said in the authentic hadith narrated by Imam al-Tirmidhi, Husayn minni wa ana min Husayn. Wallahi, how will you interpret this hadith? He said, Husayn is from me and I am from him. Ahabba Allah man ahabba Husayna. Wallahi, hardly you will hear this hadith from the people of Ahlul Sunnah. Why? Why? You're afraid they would say, he's becoming Shia. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. If Shia is to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's family, I will be the first Shia. What is, subhanAllah, what level we have reached? I am from Hussein and Hussein is from me. May Allah love the one who loves Hussein. Ahabba Allah man ahabba Hussein. He's telling you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How won't we love him? And name our kids after him. And learn about him and follow his footsteps. He stood with courage against those people who wanted to change the right way of having the leaders in Islam. He wanted to correct the mistake with a great courage. He went out with his whole family, radiallahu anhu. He was not hasty, as some people say, and he did not take precautions. No, he did take precautions, and he sent Muslim bin Aqil, his cousin, to investigate. So he took precautions, radiallahu anhu. But those people were ugly people who let him down.
If they were rude and ugly and people who love dunya and betrayed him and let him down, is it his mistake? Even though we have to know the history, dear brothers and sisters. When some of our sheikhs, they blame him, we have to learn. That cannot be right. Not because he's infallible. He is not infallible. When he discovered that they betrayed him, he asked those murderers, upon whom the curse of Allah and the curse of the angels befall. He told them, okay, let me go and meet Yazid. Or let me go to the Muslim borders, just to make ribat there, to guard the Muslim borders. Or just let me go back. They didn't. They insisted to humiliate him. But they didn't know he's the noble man, radiallahu anhu. He never accepted to be humiliated. And that's a lesson for us. That's a lesson for us. And this is why he's a master. He's a sayyid. Because our beloved said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sayyid al-shuhada Hamza. The master of the martyrs is Hamza. And a man, rajulun, a man, stood in the face of a tyrant and commanded him and advised him, then he killed him. That's what happened to Sayyidina al-Husayn radiallahu anhu wa rabbah. We learned his love from Sayyidina al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. When he said, as in the authentic hadith in Bukhari, and subhanAllah, look, the hadith about Sayyidina Abu Bakr or narrated by him are very few. This is one of them. He said, wallahi, by the one in whose hands my soul is, to be dutiful to the family members of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is dearer to me than my own family. Of course, that is the love. That is natural. And this is why do we love him, radiallahu anhu? Well, because he is the beloved of our beloved, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is love. That is natural. That is common sense. If you truly love your beloved, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will love this great man and these great people, his household. He's carrying Sayyidina al-Hasan and Sayyidina al-Husayn, radiallahu anhu, and hugging this one time and hugging this one time. And the Sahabi told him, ya Rasulullah, you love them? He said, yes. And whoever loves them has loved me. وَنْ أَحَبَّهُمَا فَقَدْ أَحَبَّنِ. If you truly love him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you truly love him, you will definitely love him. That is where the love starts from. From their connection with this great prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's mentioned in the hadith, narrated by Imam Tirmidhi and others, that, and see, I did not say Rasulullah said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm saying it's mentioned in the hadith, and this hadith, even though it's not very authentic, but it can be quoted, as we learned from our scholars. But we don't narrate it with conformity. But the meaning is very correct, that Rasulullah said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's narrated that he said, أَحِبُّ اللَّهَ لِمَا يَغْذُوكُمْ بِهِ مِنْ نِعَمِهِ. Love Allah for the blessings that He has given you. And love me because Allah loves me. And love my Ahlul Bayt because I love them. That is the common sense. We love them because they are the beloved of our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because we love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do I have how much? 5 minutes? I don't have a clock. 3 minutes? Jazakallah khair. Should put a clock here for this barrier. Husayn minni wa ana min Husayn. The commentators on this hadith, they said that he's saying Husayn is part of me and I am part of him, as if they became one thing. Radiallahu anhu. Wallahi, this hadith is amazing. So briefly, dear brothers and sisters, inshallah the imams and inshallah the guest speaker will comment more on on the virtues of these great people. Inshallah, I hope I shed some light. And the practical thing that is the result of the love. Some people, subhanAllah, they even miss the main points of the Arabic language. They say love means to follow him. That's not what love means. Love, you love him because of his actions, because of his connection with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because of his relation with him. That is the normal love, the natural love. Now, we want the result of love, dear brothers and sisters. That is why we are here. If we say we love him and we call our daughters Fatima.
If we say we love him and we call our daughters Fatima and Zainab and Ruqayya and then they come out without the proper hijab, that's not the true love. We want the result of the love. The result of the true love is to follow him, to follow them, to follow those great people, those greatest people, the family members of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Same thing, it's not enough to name our children Hussein and Hassan and Fadl and etc. And then our children or our brothers, they go and sell alcohol to others. That's not how we truly follow their footsteps. These are just quick examples. This, you can apply this to hundreds of examples in our lives. We have to follow them and to show our love by following their footsteps in every aspect of our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all of the true lovers of the family members of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise the positions of the martyrs of Karbala and all the martyrs of Islam, and particularly Sayyidina al-Hussein alayhi salam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send more blessings upon him and his family members who supported him and who died defending him, and all of their supporters. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give relief to our brothers and sisters who are suffering under the tyranny and the dictatorships of the Yazids of today, and who are following the footsteps of Yazid and his soldiers and his followers. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us on the path of Sayyidina al-Hussein to reject injustice and oppression and dictatorship, and to reject al-munkar, and to reject the changes to the way that our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left us upon. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. Jazakum Allahu khayran, barakallahu feekum, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, salli allahumma ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim tasliman kathiran ila yawmiddin, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.